She's the queen of the silver dollar. She rules the smoky kingdom. The scepter is a wine glass, and a barstool is her throne.
Even sugar there. One of my only country and western records. I quite like Sugar. Not sure about Dave though. He always comes on and ruins this song. Great chest though. that's Dave and Sugar, Queen of the Silver Dollar. Nice classic country breakbeat. Obviously that I know, if you watched my last video, because of this. Three Sinister Syllables, the greatest mixtape of all time. And I had some nice comments about that. So if you haven't got it, do check it out. It's great. And you get a bit of that, a bit of Dave and Sugar on in the mix as well. But yeah, that I think I picked it up for a quid one day. Just saw it, couldn't resist. Why not? The rest of the album is pretty terrible, I have to say. Okay, so some records to talk about, as usual. And a very mixed bag today, I think. So I'm going to start with this peculiar record, sticking with the hip hop a bit, which kind of goes with the Three Sinister Syllables. I haven't listened to it in about 20 years, and I've just started listening to it today. It's very long, so I'm about halfway through. But anyway, Prince Paul presents Prince Among Thieves. This was a very ambitious project by Prince Paul, the famed producer, probably most famous for his work with De La Soul, Grave Diggers, Beastie Boys. Yeah, very sample heavy, great sort of zany, off the wall thinking. Yeah, this is a very ambitious project which involved taking a cast of thousands, basically, and making a movie without a movie. So it's not something you can see, but you can listen to it all. And the acting is all done by a cast of hip-hop superstars, who also, many of whom appear. So you've got De La Soul appearing on this. Who else? Big Daddy Kane, Cool Keith, Biz Markie, Chub Rock, Sada X, Exhibit, and a few other people. And then you've got participation, perhaps not songs, but participation from the likes of the RZA, Everlast from House of Pain, Chris Rock, lots of big names. It's a, like I say, it's a very ambitious record. It doesn't always work, I have to say. I remember reading an interview with Prince Paul at the time, and he's very much a perfectionist when it comes to the sound of his recording. So a perfectionist to such an extent that he'd get people to record the dialogue and then he'd re-piece it together with the words and the lines that he was happiest with. So the original thing, what you hear is not actually the original thing. It's like a piece together bit of what they said. And it can sometimes sound a bit stunted, I find. Maybe it's just the bad acting. I don't know. And it tells a kind of cliched story of two people. But it's got some really, really good songs on here, actually. So not perhaps the most essential album. But when it's good, it's really great. I really like the De La Soul track, More Than You Know. MC Hustling is pretty good with Horror City. There's some other unusual ones and some nice ones here. So a curious record, but still interesting to listen to. Okay, what else have we got? Quite a lot of odds and ends. So let's go with some dodgy late 70s, early 80s soul music. One of my favourites, you know. This is by a band called Mystic Merlin. They came to fame by mixing their live shows with magic tricks, hence the name and the dodgy cover art on this album. But they're actually a pretty good band, so I think that's why they were told eventually to stop doing the magic tricks and just focus on the music. It's very nice sort of some mid-tempo slow jams, and lots of upbeat boogie disco numbers on here as well. I think the big song, Just Can't Give You Up, very nice, but a really nice one. Dark Side. What's the other one? I can't remember, but some nice slow numbers on here. So yeah, sometimes a terrible cover, it kind of pulls you in and makes you want to find out about this record. And it turned out this one was decent. So yeah, nice. Also, well, since I've got them, since we're on dodgy 80s soul, I'm just going to show some nice 7-inches. In Europe, particularly, the 7-inches all come with, or used to come with, picture sleeves, which can be really nice. So I've got a few here I was just going to show. There's a nice chairman of the board. Because the ones you see in this country, they don't tend to have the picture sleeve. LaToya Jackson. Now, if you feel the funk is a fairly forgettable A side, the B side's really good here. Lovely Is She. Nice mellow soul, just the way I like it. Nice with the picture. There's a little beaver. I think I've shown that one before, actually. Let the Good Times Roll. Spanish. Lovely. Geraldine Hunt. Again, the B-side, the A-side. It doesn't only happen at night. There's some clattering disco nonsense. But Undercover Lover, Two-Step Magic. Great. The Silvers. I love the Silvers. And Hotline, you can find anywhere. It's a fairly horrible record. But this is the German version, which has the B-side. Ain't No Doubt About It. Brilliant, bubbly two-step. Yeah, normally the B-side of Hotline is something fairly forgettable, but yeah, great, that one. And also because the album it's off is kind of hit and miss, and that's the really good song off it, so nice to have it on a little 7-inch with a nice picture sleeve. And Instant Funk. Wow. Okay. The album has this cover as well, and I'm sure it's kind of like boogie dance floor stuff. I really like the B-side. Again, it's all about the B-side. I really like the B-side. It's cool. And it's nice to have this terrible cover without it being so big. What were they thinking? The 80s. What a decade. And I like the fact that this guy here, you can see that 1,000-yard stare. He knows they look ridiculous. But anyway, it's actually got some nice music on it. So there we go. There's some sevens. And for some slightly more serious soul music, this is a new release, which I'm sure many people may have treated themselves to. Charles Stepney. Step on Step. An unusual collection that you've got here of home recordings. Obviously, he's famous for his arrangements in Chicago with huge number of musicians, perhaps most famously Rotary Connection, Minnie Riperton, Earth, Wind & Fire. I think he had a hand with some of their stuff. It's quite interesting knowing that he's all about doing the orchestrations and having big orchestral music. This is just very lo-fi, him on a keyboard with a drum machine with occasional bits of this and that added in, some synths and things. But really nice, really pleasant listening. And actually, the more I listen to it, the more I warm to it. Yeah, because when I first heard it, I was like, okay, right. So it's demos and they're quite sparse, a lot of them. But the more you play it, really great. And you can see the thinking, the attention to melody that he had, the amazing ear. I was wondering perhaps it would have been better on CD, because it's a nice one to have just sort of leaving on and playing through the house. But it's on this very nice double vinyl, which I think you can get on gold. I've got black here, but yeah, it's a rather nice package. Very thick vinyl with this Obi strip. I'm not quite sure the point of an Obi strip, but people seem to love them. So there we go. But yeah, no, really worth checking this out, I think. If you like very well, exquisitely presented, reissued. Well, it's not a reissue, is it? It's never been released before. This is really, really nicely done. And it's very tender, I think, as well, partly because his daughters are heavily involved and they actually feature with little recorded interviews between some of the tracks. But yeah, really definitely worth checking this record out, whether on CD or vinyl, I think it would go. And one more, which I've been listening to a lot lately, and I'm afraid it's a very difficult record to find in Europe, but it's a compilation, a salsa compilation, Los Duros de la Salsa, and it has some quite hard to get numbers on it, and some fantastic, fantastic music on it. Just looking at the list here, Rainfall by Tito Puente is a lovely, really nice vibes heavy opener that they've got. This song, Un Tipo Liberado, is a Larry Harlow song. It's absolutely wonderful. Larry Harlow, obviously a bit of a legend when it comes to Latin music, but I find a lot of his music, it's great, but it doesn't always hit that sweet spot for me. But this particular song is absolutely brilliant. It does have very good lyrics as well, which always helps, but it's a wonderful, wonderful song. So yeah, I would definitely recommend seeking some of these out. Another great one here, Amil, Nelson y sus Locos Drums, is basically the Latin version of Happy Hardcore. It's just two notes and lots of crazy drums. All the timbales going wild. But yeah, really, really great stuff. Even the very end there, Mr. Bongo himself, the original Mr. Bongo, Eddie Cano. Well, no, Jack Costanzo, I think, was the original Mr. Bongo. His version of Chopsticks, a children's song that you might learn on the piano, but here it's done with fire, I have to say. But yeah, really, really unusual. Very nice compilation, that one. But like I say, not an easy one to find, but I have enjoyed it a lot. So I think that's some of the music I've been listening to. Bit of hip hop, bit of soul, bit of Latin, bit of country. Hope everybody's well. Been enjoying a lot of videos, lots of very philosophical videos of late. Sometimes I wish I had something I could articulate my feelings about music in the same way that other people do, but it's really great to watch, so really enjoy it. Anyway, until the next time, hope everybody's well. All the best. Can't give you up, just can't give you up.